Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and today I'm going to be talking about walls. I'm going to be talking about interior and exterior walls and how you can make them look more organic, more real, because I'm kind of a firm believer that like the simpler the object in the scene is, the more harder it is to render it photorealistically. Walls are, you know, a perfect example of that. So I'm going to show you this one trick that I use for my walls. I'm also going to show you an upgraded, like more complex version on how to get the wall to look even more realistic. And the procedure is generally super simple. It takes you 10 seconds to do. Oh, one thing to add, for those of you that don't know, I'm planning to do some sort of workshop. It's going to be like a modeling rendering workshop, and it would generally be like, you know, a group, like groups of people, and I'm going to be interacting with you guys where, you know, I'm going to give you some assignments and I'm going to kind of check how you work, what you do, and I'm going to try to improve your workflow, way of thinking on how to model things, on how to approach problems, etc., etc. So if you would be interested in some sort of workshop, please write down in the comments below. You know, I would like to hear, you know, like what's the interest in this. On the last video, a lot of people said that they would love it, but for those of you who hear it now the first time, just write down what you think, and that's pretty much it. Let's continue. So here I have the scene that I made, and this one just has the plain wall with nothing on it. So you can see like it's just a basic object. One thing that I need to mention for like this whole technique to work, your wall need to be kind of one solid object. You cannot have multiple objects, you know, to kind of have the wall. It has to be kind of connected. So in general, I'm going to be adding two things: chamfered corners and bumpiness on the wall. And I'm not talking material bump, I'm talking real bump. So this is the video that I made a couple months ago, 5 things which expose your renders. You can see like where the skirting board is, how the wall is actually spaced out from the skirting board, where here it's actually pressed against the skirting board. Even here, like, just look at it, spaced out here, pressed against, spaced out, and this bumpiness kind of happens on all the walls everywhere. One thing that 3D does, which is abnormally unrealistic in real life, is to have things absolutely perfect. Like all your wall corners and everything are always like in a perfect straight line. That doesn't happen in reality. So I'm going to show you a quick way on how you can just mess this whole thing up, and it's going to look super nice. So just do this. Select your wall, add subdivide modifier, set size to be 7 centimeters, add a chamfer on top of that. For the chamfer, I have a 5mm preset. What that preset does is adds amount of 0.5 centimeters, segments to 2. You have to turn on inset and have inset type to flow loop and set the amount to 0.25. After that, add a noise modifier. For the noise, set scale to be 800, turn on fractal and set roughness to be 0.1. And for the strength, you just need to put 1.5 centimeter on all axes. And that's pretty much it. That's done. Now, of course, let me show you the before and afters. And this is the final result. Now let's kind of dissect what actually happened here. So because of our chamfer here, you can see that now we got these highlights there, and you can actually see like that faint white line happening like in the corners of the walls. That's one thing. Because of the noise modifier, you can actually notice how all the lines, like all the vertical, whatever lines, all of them are just slightly wavy everywhere. And that's actually what's happening in real life. Like you can feel here that this is not a straight line. It's kind of, you know, wavy everywhere, etc. Of course, to produce all this, we do have to have the subdivide modifier, because otherwise our noise is not going to, you know, shift or bump anything. Another cool thing to notice is when you look at the shadows in the walls, you can feel how the shadow is like slightly curvy, even though the corner of the window is actually very straight. Now, if we kind of compare that to the original image that does not have these effects, the original looks like this. You can like super feel like this is the straight line, where with this, you just get that kind of, you know, organic, natural kind of feel to it. I mean, look at those shadows here. See how this one is curvy and this one is like super straight. You can feel like the chamfers here and the curviness here. You don't have any of that. Now, if I go back to the video where we saw that curviness and bumpiness of the wall, you see like things being pushed away from the skirting board and here pressed against. And now if I go back to my render, I've just switched to a corner view, you can actually see the same effects happening here. And the cool part is, even if you look like from this main shot, you can actually see the spacing happening. Like here you can see it's getting darker, here it's pressed against the wall, here it's darker again. So all those effects are kind of transitioned here. Now another thing is, if for example, you like the whole bumpy wavy effect of everything, but you don't like how it creates those holes where the skirting board is, like that spacings, because those spacings are always kind of filled with some sort of silicone or something, but you know, like as the apartment gets older, it kind of deteriorates or whatever, and it just gets lost and you get those cracks. But if you don't want to have these, there is one trick also that you can do here. You can click on your chamfer here and just type volume select, choose volume select, choose vertex mode, and scroll down where it says mesh object. In the mesh object, you can select your skirting board and then click use soft selection. And now you can generally see the selection being created because of that skirting board. But since you don't want the noise here, but you want it everywhere else, you can just click on the invert button, and now when you go to your noise, and if I switch of course to my corner camera, you can literally see how now there is no spacing on that skirting board, but that bumpiness is actually everywhere in the room. Now, a friend of mine has asked me, he said, well, this kind of looks messy. You have this web of polygons everywhere, like why don't you just use displacement on the wall? Well, there's a couple of reasons why I don't want to use displacement here. First, like I'm probably going to have a couple of other objects in my scene where I already use displacement, and just imagining the fact that I'm putting also additional displacement, you know, on like a whole wall of everything, it just feels like an overkill. On the other hand, how displacement works, for example, in F-Storm, bro, pretty much one pixel on the screen is one polygon, speaking of how dense the displacement is, meaning that in your render, you have just infused your renders with millions of polygons because of it. Where in my scenario, like this whole room, it has, I think, like 13,000 polygons, not to mention the fact that displacement tends to break off on hard corners. Like you're gonna have two corners and displacement is just gonna do that weird shift and you're just gonna get a crack. And I don't know, it just feels too risky kind of. On the other hand, this took me 10 seconds to create for displacement. Well, you might be having fun with it for at least a minute. Plus, it's heavy to render, so. But if these polygons kind of bother you, there is a potential fix for that. So, if you select all three of your modifiers here, and if you right-click, you have the option off in viewport, off in render. If you click off in viewport, the effect is not going to be visible in the viewport, but it will only be visible in the render. Unfortunately, this does not work with F-Storm. I'm also certain that it doesn't work with Corona, since Corona has to have everything visible in the viewport for it to be displayed in the render. So yeah, if in general your rendering engine supports this, you're goddamn lucky. Anyhow, one thing that's, you know, very important to mention, if you are planning to use this, and if you are planning to kind of put this effect on, for example, an entire building or something, you might not want to use a subdivide of 7 centimeters. If it's a building, you might want to go with like 40 centimeters or something like that, you know, because you don't need such dense polygons. But yeah, in general, cool thing about this whole method is that it's non-destructive, meaning that you can modify your base walls on the fly. So for example, if I do this, that, and just, I don't know, add this and, you know, some slices here, and let's say extrude it here, I can just activate all my modifiers and it's all gonna look the way it should. It's all gonna have all the respective kind of effects. And of course, you can copy paste them from one object to another, and that's pretty much it. That's pretty much how you can get all those nice curves in your walls, and you know, for them to feel more organic, like look at those shadows, how they're curving nicely, etc, etc. But now we're gonna switch to this little bit more complicated method on how to do it. Oh, before we go to the advanced version of how to create walls, I just want to give a quick shout out to Evermotion. Evermotion has Arc Models Volume 291 that's up now, up to 25% off. So head over to their website. If you decide to get Arc Models Volume 291, you're gonna get this whole room with all the props and everything in it. You even get this creepy ass mouse there. But yeah, in general, look at this. This is filled with props, cushions, like whatever you want, like coffee tables, flowers, props, blankets, you name it. I think it's a very, very good pack. Let's continue with the video. But now we're gonna switch to this little bit more complicated method on how to do it. And there's a reason for that. Whenever builders come and build your apartment, your house, or whatever, there are certain corners that it's easy for them to make like perfectly straight, and there are some corners that it's actually very hard for them to get perfectly straight. So the inside corners, like these ones, you see like this one, the insides here, they are actually in practice, they're very hard to get straight and they tend to be very bumpy. Although the corners that are kind of pointing out instead of pointing in, like pointing out like these ones here, so like the outer part of this hole in the wall, like these corners, they can be very, very straight. And there is a way how you can actually force those to use minimal or none of the noise that I'm adding here. And that's actually achievable by using data channels. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So let me just minimize all this. Click on your chamfer, and this is where you want to place data channel. So just click data channel and press it here. Go to presets and click the dirt map. So press the load button here. Now your whole object is going to turn green. And what the dirt map channel does, it pretty much kind of highlights, as you can see, like the cornery parts. So this is what you're going to do. You can just kind of replicate what I did here from now on. By the way, I'm no expert in data channels, so if any one of you, whatever I'm going to show here, knows how to do that better, please share that in the comments. Okay, so since I want to kind of remove the whole noise effect only from the outer corners, and that's the blue ones that you like that you see here, I'm going to click on my curvature there, and I'm just going to put the convex option to be 0.5. That will remove the inner corners. The next thing that I want to do, I just need to increase the scale value here. So I don't know, I've set the number 25. After that, you want to click to your add operator here and just scroll down where it says the smooth operator in under the process operators. So smooth, and just add it in between here. The smooth one, it actually kind of gives a nice effect. It can kind of blur out selections nicely. You see like this. So I'm just going to keep it very low. So I'm going to set it to, I don't know, number 2. I don't know, to be honest, if I even need it. I think I do. Okay, now next, I'm going to add normalize operator. So for the normalize, I'm just going to place it here. And from this point, I'm actually going to delete the vertex output because I want to have the edge output. And since these two are vertices, I need to add convert to subobject type, and it needs to be on the edge mode. And after that, I just need to scroll down a little bit more and click on edge output. And now this edge selection is kind of, you know, a selection of effect. And now when I apply my noise modifier on top of that, you can see that our whole here has a straight, you know, straight outer corner edges. I mean, just look, if I turn off data channel, like turn it off, you see how it gets bended. And again, cool thing is this is also non-destructible. So you can just select like this area here and, you know, I don't know, add a cut here and just, let's say, move this down. And what happens is you can see the data channel kind of recognizes those outer corners, and my noise is not going to be affecting those parts, but it will be affecting like the inner corner parts. And that's generally it. This is the room, how it looks like. And like, even if I compare it now to the first version where I didn't have any of these effects, I think the effect is very nice, and it just kind of, you know, gives that organic kind of feel to everything. And that's pretty much it. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Evermotion, as usual, thank you for sponsoring this video, and thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.